She lightens my sadness, she livens my day. She bursts with a kind of madness my well-ordered ways. My happiest mistake, the ache of my life. You must meet my wife. She bubbles with pleasure, she glows with surprise, disrupts my accustomed leisure and ruffles my ties. I don't know, even know quite how it began. You must meet my wife, my Anne. 1,000 whims to which I give in, since her smallest tear turns me ashen. I never dreamed that I could live in so completely demented, contented a fashion, so sun-like, so winning, so unlike a wife. I do think that I'm beginning to show signs of life. Don't ask me how at my age one still can grow. If you met my wife, you'd know.
Dear Frederick, I'm just longing to meet her sometime.
She sparkles.
How pleasant.
She twinkles.
How nice.
Her youth is a sort of present.
Whatever the price.
The incandescent, what the
light
of my life. You must meet my wife.
Yes, I must. I really must now.
She flutters.
How charming.
She twitters.
My word.
She floats.
Isn't that alarming? What is she? A bird?
She makes me feel I'm what?
A very old man?
Yes, no! Oh, but
I must meet your Gertrude.
My Anne.
Sorry, Anne.
She loves my voice, my walk, my mustache, the cigar, in fact, that I'm smoking. She'll watch me puff until it's just ash. Then she'll say the cigar, but
bizarre, but you're joking.
She dotes on
your dimple,
my snoring.
How dear.
Point is, she's really simple.
Yes, that much seems clear.
She gives me funny names,
like?
All dry as dust.
Wouldn't she just?
You must meet my wife.
If I must, yes, I must.
A sea of whims that I submerge in, yet so lovable in repentance. Unfortunately, still a virgin. Buddy, you can't force a flower.
Don't finish that sentence. She's monstrous.
She's frightened.
Unfeeling.
Unversed. She'd strike you as unenlightened.
No, I'd strike her first.
Her reticence, her apprehension.
Her crust.
No,
yes,
no,
yes,
you
Frederick.
You must meet my wife.
Let me get my hat and my knife.
What was that?
I must meet your wife.
Yes,
I must.
It's a little things you do together, do together, do together, that make perfect relationships.
The hobbies you pursue together,
savings you accrue together,
looks you misconstrue together,
that make marriage a joy.
It's the little things you share together,
swear together,
wear together,
that make perfect relationships.
The concerts you enjoy together,
neighbors you annoy together,
children you destroy together, that keep marriage intact.
It's not so hard to be married when to maneuver as one. It's not so hard to be married, and Jesus Christ, is it fun?
It's sharing little winks together,
drinks together,
kinks together,
that make marriage a joy.
It's bargains that you shop together,
cigarettes you stop together,
clothing that you swap together, that make perfect relationships.
Mm-hmm.
It's not talk of God and the decade ahead that allows you to get through the worst. It's I do and you don't and nobody said that and who brought the subject up first? It's the little things. The little things, the little things, the little things.
It's the little ways we try together.
Cry together. Lie together. That make perfect relationships.
Becoming a cliche together.
Growing old and gray together.
Withering away together.
That make marriage a joy. It's not so hard to be married.
It's much the simplest of crimes.
It's not so hard to be married.
I've done it 3 or 4 times. It's people that you hate together.
Bait together.
Date together. That make marriage a joy.
It's things like using force together.
Shouting till you're hoarse together.
Getting a divorce together. That make perfect relationships. Kiss, kiss.
I remember sky. It was blue as ink, or at least I think. I remember sky. I remember snow. Thumbtacks coming down like lint, and it made you squint when the wind would blow, and ice like vinyl on the street, cold as silver, white as sheet. Rain like strings and changing things, like leaves. I remember leaves, green as spearmint, crisp as paper. I remember trees. There is coat racks spread like broken umbrellas, and parks and bridges, ponds and zoos, ruddy faces, muddy shoes, light and noise and bees and boys and days. I remember days, or at least I try. But as years go by, there is so of haze, and the bluest ink isn't really sky. And at times I think I would gladly die of sky.